Hey, how's it going everybody? It's your bro, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys the difference between local and global variables and objects in Java, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright guys and gals, I'm going to explain the difference between local and global variables and objects. So anything that is local is declared inside a method and is visible only to that method. Anything that is global is declared outside a method, but within a class, and is visible to all parts of a class, including any methods found within that class. Here's an example. We're going to create a program where we will roll a dice. So let's handle that with an additional class. So let's go to File, New, Class, and I will call this class DiceRoller, click finish. I need to create an instance of this class, so within my main method, I'm going to create an instance of my dice roller class. Dice roller, I'll call this instance dice roller for short, equals new dice roller. Within our dice roller class, we'll create a constructor for this class. It's the same name as the class name, plus a method to roll a dice for us. So the return type is void, and we'll call this method roll. We'll need to declare a few things, an instance of the random class, plus an integer variable to hold our result. So let's create an instance of the random class, random, random equals new, random. We'll need an import as well, so include that, import java.util.Random, and an integer variable, and we'll call this number, int number, and we'll set this equal to 0 for now. And lastly, within the constructor, we'll call the roll method. So let's set up the roll method. We're going to take our number variable, set this equal to random.nextInt. We want the numbers 1 through 6, so we'll pass in 6 to this method of nextInt plus 1. And we're adding plus 1 because we would normally get the numbers 0 through 5. And then with a print line statement, we'll display our number to the console window. Here's the issue we're running into. Both our instance of the random class plus our integer number variable are local to our constructor. So anything that is local is declared inside a method and visible only to that method. Well, our constructor counts as a method, so the instance of the random class and our number are only visible to anything within our constructor. Our roll method does not have access to our instance of the random class plus our number. There are two ways in which we can solve this. One is that we can pass these as arguments to a method, and the other way is that we can declare these as global. So let's begin by passing these as arguments. So we're going to pass our instance of the random class plus our number as arguments to our roll method. So let's do that. We're going to pass random and number to our roll method, but we'll need to set up some parameters. This will accept a random argument as well as an integer argument, and we'll call this number. So this will work just fine then. So we have a 4, and a 4, and a 6. So the other way in which we can write this, I'm just going to reverse our changes. We can declare our instance of the random class and our integer number variable as global. These are declared outside a method, but within a class, and it's visible to all parts of a class. So in place of declaring these inside of the constructor for the dice roller, we're going to declare our instance of the random class and our number outside of this method, our constructor. And with our random class, we'll finish instantiating this within the constructor. So let's declare random outside of the constructor as well as our number outside of the constructor as well. So now our roll method has access to our instance of the random class plus our number because these are global. They are declared outside of the method, but within a class. Technically, we don't even really need to assign a value anymore to our number. We can simply just declare these. So this will work just the same as it did before. It's just another way of writing this program. We rolled a 5, and we rolled a 4. So that's the main difference between local and global. Anything that is local is declared inside a method and visible only to that method. Anything that is global is declared outside a method, but within a class, and is visible to all parts of a class. So that's the differences between local and global items in Java. If you would like a copy of this code, I will post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the main differences between local and global items in Java.
Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.